I've got it sanded down to 600 wet. I'm fixing some tape that needs to be fixed. I've cleaned it once, I gotta clean it two more times. I did wax and grease remover, then I'm gonna do glass cleaner, then I'm gonna do rubbing alcohol, and it all has to dry, and then I'm ready to paint. I'm gonna do three coats, a very light three coats, and then let it flash overnight, and then it'll be painted. I've been taping up some spots that need to be fixed so it's got a good line. But now I'm gonna clean it. I just cleaned it with wax and grease remover. Now I'm gonna do the glass cleaner. And then finally I will do rubbing alcohol. Once that all dries off, flashes, then I'll be able to go ahead and do, you know, paint. And know what you've all been waiting for. Paint. I just cleaned it down to, well, it's sanded to 600 wet, and I just cleaned it with glass cleaner and alcohol, 91%. So I'm gonna let that flash off for another 10 minutes. Get a tack cloth, clean it off one final time, and then here we go, we're gonna spray. Okay, let's go mix some paint, and I'll be right back. Hi, I'm wet sanding the paint, even though it was perfect, to 600. There was like a dot right here. Of course, then I just burned through right here, which sucks. A little bit through here. On this fender, there was a dent right here and a dent right here, and I pulled them out, and in the process, screwed up the paint. Like I sanded way too far, but obviously I've repainted it. It looks fine and the dent is gone. So let's not screw it up again. So I'm gonna sand these doors. I'm gonna hold off on the fender because I painted it probably half an hour ago. I'm gonna let it cook. In fact, I'm gonna put this over here. So let it go. I use these little paintless dent removal thingies to pull the little dent. And I mean, it was almost not there. But you could see it in the reflection if you kind of turned your head. It just bugged me. I probably didn't need to sand this to 600 because it was so good. But I'm trying to make it even better. So after this, I'll clean it off. I will fix this crap. I've got some touch-up paint. I can do that, which won't matter. And hopefully I won't have to break out the gun again to spray it. Sand it all to 600. And then clean it up and then spray the clear. And then sand the clear down and then buff the clear and then hopefully it'll be done. So this is wet sanding to 600 after the paint job was damn near perfect. Now, I have this and this and this and that and that and that and that and that and that. I think that's all. Well, and I'm gonna redo this. But I fixed the dent that I wanted to fix, right? There was a ding right here that bugged me. I fixed it, but in the process of fixing it, I screwed up the paint. So now I've cleaned it off, I've sanded it all down to 600, wet. I cleaned off the kind of the sludge it makes. I'm gonna clean it off with the glass cleaner, not the alcohol, because the alcohol is what screwed the paint. And then respray it. At least once, maybe twice. What are we gonna have, 5-6 coats on here?
Jury's gonna look good, and I hope the hell it comes out as good as it did. Because I really,
I don't know. It was like the best paint job I ever did. It was really good. And now, I mean, I'll have the same settings, I'll have the same paint. I'll make sure it's clean, la-di-da-di-da, but I am not sanding it back down until the clear's on it, if I have to. Like, I have to sand this clear because it has too much orange peel, but I believe it's because I listened to the guy on YouTube and turned my pressure up really high. So know your settings on your gun, on your paint gun, because if you just listen to somebody on the internet, they might even be right for what they are doing. But I'm in my garage in the middle of winter, and the only reason it's warm enough is because of these heaters. And I'm sure that has a lot to do with the way things are turning out. So, anyway, I'm gonna spray it again. They say the prep is 90%. It really is. If I would have seen that dent that I did not see at all, because I fixed other ones, I would have been done. I would have been clearing right now. Is it the end of the world? No, but it just feels like I just did this. All right, we're gonna call this coat number 4. This is sanded down, they call it color sanded, 600 wet after I painted, because I screwed up that. There was a little ding in there that I had to fix because it was driving me crazy, but in the process, screwed up a bunch of other stuff. So what I'm gonna do now is we'll just call this coat number 4, even though it was done. And if coat number 4 works, then we'll be happy, and then we'll spray clear. Here we go.
I was about to leave, the cap was on tight, and I dumped a bunch of it on here. And I'm out of paint, so now if I didn't get it with this coat, I gotta go buy more paint. Coat number 4. Looks pretty good. Set it flash for about 20 minutes, and I'll do another coat. Look how beautiful it is, boys and girls. It's like I knew what I was doing. Still gonna clear it. A little trash right there. Dent is gone. Bye bye, dent. Hello, dog hair, whatever you are. But it's ready to clear. But I'm gonna wait till tomorrow. For you, it'll be now.
Hello. Welcome back. I've been sanding the hood, wet sanding it, because I'm going to, I had to fix the edge here where it was had corrosion. But then I'm gonna respray the clear coat here in just a minute. So I wanna respray this too. Hopefully it'll match. If it doesn't, I'm gonna sand it down to 400. And then repaint the hood too, which will suck, but needs to be done. But if you screw it up, then you just gotta take longer to fix it. Or just do crappy quality, which I don't wanna do. I mean, I don't even have to do this hood. I could just put black vinyl over it, because I've got the material and I've thought about doing it anyway. I want it to look good though, even if it's under the black vinyl. Somebody might take it off someday and go, what the hell happened to the hood? You'd not have to be as careful with the X pattern, because it's really not shaping it, and it's just taking off any nibs, or in this case, kind of the first layer of the clear coat.
So I'll just, after this dries, go grab some paint. Just a little, I got some spare paint, and so I don't have to waste a bunch mixing it.
I work for this trucking company, washing the tractor trailers. And the guy at my first day sees the boss. He says to me, shiny high knees is a b-. And I'm like 18, just no idea about anything in the world. I'm like, okay. He meant like the back of the truck, if it was chrome, was hard to clean. What do you know? All I wanted to do when I got this car was replace those doors and this fender and be done.
Yeah.
It seems kind of comical to me now that I really believe that. I mean, I believed it 100%. These little vents were hard to get out. Each one had a screw that wouldn't come out. I finally got them out. That one was pretty simple. There's just some tabs underneath. You push up and it pulls right out. I'm gonna repaint those kind of a semi-gloss black, as well as the grill. So the whole front end is gonna be brand new. Now, if when I'm done, this doesn't match, all I'm gonna do is sand it down 400, 600, the whole, you know, everything, quarter and whatever, and then paint it. Being partially colorblind, I have to rely on whoever's mixing the paint because I can't tell. I remember when I was doing the general, I would be asking my wife, is this the right shade or is this the right shade? And eventually I got him to learn how to tint it right, I guess, or I don't know, because it was from 1970. It's Corvette Flame Red is what I painted the general. And this is Destroyer Gray, so that's what it came with. PDN or whatever the code is. And you think, since it's such a new car, it's going to be on file, then you just, you know, mix it up, which is what I hope they did. It looks like it did, but you never know till the clear is on. Anyway, I'm going to dry this off, get it ready, mix up some paint, spray it beautifully, very lightly, two or three coats. Here's what we've got. Sanded down to 600. First 400, then 600 wet. And you can see where I've burned through. And I'm thinking maybe the reason there's a color difference, I'm hoping the reason there's a color difference, is because of where I put the icing. So it's making a little off. It's time to spray the clear. There's the hood. Let's see, does that look good? That looks pretty good. If the other side is lighter than this, I'll repaint it this color. If it's not, I'll be done. Is the same color. Hell, I don't know. But it is definitely orange peely. I'm gonna just use what I have left of the clear. So far, no runs. Hopefully, I don't screw that up. There's a hair right there, but if I'm gonna have to come up anyway, it doesn't really matter. So I'm just gonna put what I have left on there. All right, here is drying for, I don't know, 40 minutes, half an hour, something like that. Definitely super orange peely. I like the color, but I don't think it's the same as this color. Hi, wife. So it's super orange peely, which won't matter because I got to cut and buff it anyway. But I just don't think it's the same color as this. Here comes my color expert to let us know now. It's the same? Okay, good. But luckily, I got a hot wife, and that's all I need, really. Okay, thanks for watching. Next one will be cutting and buffing, sanding the clear down, basically. Bye.